Okay, we're live here from the Big E for the Big Train Show, and I am speaking with the
Tommy Robichaux. Yep. Speaking of Tommy Robichaux, I'm the president of the Bristol S-Gage Club. Just a quick story about the Bristol S-Gage Club. Bristol S-Gage Club was founded in 1948. It's the oldest S-Gage Club in North America. We're competing against Europe as being the oldest in the world.
Wow.
We do this show every year. S-Gage, a little bit about S-Gage, it's the old American Flyer, but there's a lot of manufacturers out there that's building S-Gage today, Lionel, MTH, Desplaines, really nice size. It's in between HO and O, so it's really prototypical. It's two rails, which is nice. It's not the three rail O stuff. We run a lot of technology here, so we run anywhere from DCC, which is Digital Command Control. We run Lionel's TMCC, we run AC, we run DC. We have a lot of variety of options that we can run this layout on, which makes it very diverse for our club members who have a bunch of different stuff and not everybody has the same stuff. So this is a layout that's owned by the club. It's not owned individual modules. That's why if you look at the layout, it all blends together. And we do about four shows a year. And we have a lot of fun. We have an aging club members, so any interest in joining the S-Gage world and the Bristol S-Gage Club, look us up online, and we'll be more than happy to accommodate you. Thank you.
So right now, we're looking at America's first S-Gage Club, founded in 1948, Bristol S-Gage Railroaders at the Big E. And you want to take the time to come down and visit this display. It's absolutely fabulous. They have four buildings dedicated to the railroad hobbyists. So that's where, so you're standing here to be seen over there.
In front of this engine. If you look at this engine right here.
Okay.
We disassembled one of those GoPro helmet cameras. You can see the camera sticking out of the nose of it. So whatever the front of that, it's looking down that straightaway right now. Right?
Wow, that's really clever. Yeah. It was funny because I seen over there and then the lady was telling me if you use that TV, it's clearer. You know, yeah. So filming it, so that's what we're going to do.
Yep, it's that car right there.
If you want to be on TV, if it's okay, we can go over there and then he can wave. You want to do that?
I don't care.
Would you like to do that? Then you'll be on the TV.
You want to be on TV with it?
Welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, we're visitors here at the Big E, and the big excitement of the day is all about trains.
Exactly.
And if you could just introduce yourself to our viewing audience and tell us a little something about the setup here.
Right. My name's Bill Colwell. I'm part of the Mohegan and Pequot's Model Railroad Club. It's a multi-scale club, and G-scale is one of the scales that you see here. and I'm more or less the coordinator for handling logistics and setup for this part of the organization. And we're from various parts of Connecticut, Massachusetts, Rhode Island. The members come; they're mostly based up on the shoreline, going towards New London and Groton. But a lot of the members are based in Central Connecticut, Rhode Island, Massachusetts. And this is our one big show a year that we pull all the stops out and bring out all the stuff.
That's why we didn't want to miss out. Now, do you have a website for your...
The Mohegan and Pequots do have a website. I don't remember the address off the top of my head, but if you just Google search for Mohegan and Pequot Railroad Club, it'll bring you to a link. There's also on that site a link to the Central Connecticut G-Gagers, which all the members of the G-Gage group are co-members of. So it's really two groups into one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's the way it's set up, but we're all part of the Mohegan and Pequots and...
Sort of like brother clubs.
It's an affiliation for us.
Mm-hmm.
But we're very much members of the Mohegan and Pequots, and they're a multi-scale club.
Okay, and you said again that this size, the scale is?
G-gauge. Yep.
Okay.
It's made mostly to go, these trains and anything associated with it can go outside. It can be put in the garden. It can be left outside to weather the weather.
Really?
And yes, I mean, there are hobbyists that actually do plow snow off their tracks. There are cars with plows and trains and engines with plows that'll clear the tracks. But it's made to go outside and be left out, with the exception of bringing in engines and cars and stuff. The buildings, the track can all be stayed outside year-round. And we do it on a modular basis only because G-Gage started in roughly 1968 and kind of started to come into being in the early 1980s. So a lot of people had stuff just laying in their closets. The modular concept had been known before in other scales. A group out in California created a standard that most of us follow, and this layout is based on, at least when putting it together, is based on a known standard that's coming out of Southern California.
Yeah, because we were looking at them afterwards. We're going to walk around and then film the whole display right there.
But and if you want to come inside to make it more convenient for the cameraman, that's fine.
Okay.
So, whatever could be for you to get the right picture you want is where you can be.
Okay, that's great.
So, like I said, I basically do all the coordination for the group.
Well, it's a lot that takes place in this. And it's really, I appreciate that.
No, it's every hobby is a labor of love in many respects, and it takes many talents to pull it all together. And fortunately, we have a good roster of individuals that have a diverse talent and are very good team players and getting the job done.
Well, that's what's keeping the excitement on the hobby going.
Yeah, and as this hobby's getting old, as the people in this hobby are getting older, really the baby boomers and what was left, the tail end of the baby boomers generation, these big shows become more important.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're one of the last best venues. It's probably the most recent venue to get people more exposure to this, and this show always does well as far as the numbers every year, as far as attendance.
To have a display in four buildings dedicated to the train.
Yeah, and it's a lot of these bigger shows are turning into more regional or coastal shows. Like you have this show for the East Coast, you have a couple of large shows out in the West Coast. There's a show in Pennsylvania that they do, but this show has been around forever, mm-hmm. to the best of my knowledge. So it's really the best venue to continue to gain interest in model trains, regardless of the scale the individual is in or going into.
Okay, well, thank you.
You're welcome.
again, this is the New Haven G Scale. It says Memories of the New Haven Railroad, custom paint work, Wayne Yassi. So here it is. We have the old-fashioned drive-in movie that I still think there's people around that remember that. And the displays are absolutely fantastic here, even having one with the police. So here comes the next train down the track.
My name is Stuart Dom. I'm with the Mohegan Pequot Model Railroad Club. We're located in the southeastern Connecticut area of New London, Groton area. We don't have a permanent home, but we are a modular club, and we've been a modular club for since 1980. So it's been quite a few years. We've been at this show for 30 years. This is our 30th anniversary coming to the Amherst Model Railroad Show for our club. We are largely an HO scale group, although we now have, which is what you're looking at right now, is the HO, our modular club, which is the largest part of the club. But we do have G scale, which is just across the aisle there, and we also have a couple of Lionel and O scale stuff at the other end of this module. So we got a lot of diversity in the club. We have about 65 members, of which probably 40 of them are from the HO group. We're primarily interested in HO scale railroading. This layout is the largest layout we can set up during the year. It consists of about 80 modules, separate modules. Modules are generally, or for the most part, owned individually by the members. There are groups, we have about 18 members that could have all these modules. The one that I'm standing behind has about a 42-foot module. It happens to be mine, but that doesn't matter. We all use the same stuff. So that's the nature of our club, and we enjoy being here. It's fun to watch the kids play and then to look at the trains. That's what we're here for.
People, if they want to know more, okay, about your club, how can they reach you after the Big E show?
We have a wonderful website. It's called www.mprr.org, and it's available for anybody to go look at. It's been well maintained, and I think we're very proud of it, and they can find out all the information about our past history, our current modules, our past modules. Everything about the club is on that website, so we're very proud of that too.
That's good, and this is what we want to let the public know, that it's just not at this show, that you are year-round, and they can find out as much as they want.
Yes, absolutely.
And contact your group directly.
That is correct. We also do a number of shows throughout the year. We go to a show in West Hartford at the Conard High School. Mm-hmm. And we were supporting a show in Willimantic, but they stopped doing their show. But anytime we're invited, we like to go out and do shows. We're very proud of the fact that we've attended 3 national train shows with our HO modular group. The one here in Hartford in 2000, I think it was 5, or 9, it might have been 9. We attended the one in Cleveland 2 years ago, and we attended the one in Indianapolis this past year. And I think we're very proud of our achievements in that regard.
Well, everything we've seen here is just so beautiful, and you see the detail that is applied towards each particular section along here. It's very impressive.
Thank you very much. We certainly enjoy doing it.
Okay, well, thank you for taking some time out of your busy schedule to help educate us.
There's another one on the other side, so focus. These are very quiet, smooth when they run.
Thank you. We worked very hard to get to that. You weren't here earlier when they were crashing. Yes, we do that too.
Well, I can imagine with all that you have going on here, all the different tracks and things.
Sometimes we're lucky that, come on, We know what we're doing. But thank you so much for your kind words.
Well, it's...
You inspire us to do it one more time.
All right, all right. Well, actually, we're taping this for our cable TV, and then it's going to go up on YouTube. So there'll be other people will be able to access it. So
YouTube. Don't break your camera.
Hey, they already did it with me, not to worry.
Oh, okay, good, good. What station is it? Are you local here in Springfield?
In East Long Meadow, yeah. It's an East Long Meadow Community Access.
Okay.
TV. And so what we do is they show it, of course, on our local cable, but then also all the different videos and shows that my husband and I have done, they have a section that says Out with Sue and Al.
You guys have been doing this for years, haven't you?
Yes.
Yeah, because I had a couple of guys that came up to me, you're a celebrity, you've been on Facebook. I went, man, 15 and 16, I got you over there. And I'm going, I don't remember. With time, with age.
That's right, that's right. But the interest in the trains haven't stopped. People just like to know all about it.
The thing that I try to do is I'm trying to get the young kids interested.
Yes.
You know, because you and I are over 21.
A little bit.
Okay. And every morning I wake up, I find another ache and a pain. So if I got an 18-year-old that wants to play.
And can also bend over better to pick up things and stuff like that.
You know, I'll hand you the throttle. I'll give you an inch. Just don't break anything.
Yep. I'll be your mentor.
Okay, I'll do that too. But, you know, because our hobby is actually not flourishing as it should. We don't have a lot of young kids interested. We really don't.
Well, I think sports takes up a lot of that, because we've seen that in some of the other clubs.
TV and video games. We cannot compete.
No.
And it's a shame. Yeah, sports and academics. But I remember this when I was a kid.
My husband also.
Yep. I remember also being able to sit beside the track and watch the trains. I can't do that now. But yes, I still find this fascinating. Harder to see it, but still fascinating.
That's why I put the glasses on.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
It's a lot easier to read what this is.
Oh, yeah. I'll get to that. But thank you guys for doing what you do. Because of you, my wife knows where I'm at.
Yeah, did you see? He is here. But he is also talking to another woman, I hate to tell you.
She does that. She knows that. She knows that.
Okay, well, thank you so much.
Well, thank you so much.
Oh, what was your name?
Bill. Bill Evans.
Okay, Bill. Very nice to meet you.
It's
to
a pleasure.
A little bit.
I hope to be here next year.
Okay.
Come back and visit.
Okay.
Bring him, too.
I'll make sure. He's the other half of the team. Without him, me holding the microphone only does so much, you know?
You're doing the hard part. He's just over there.
Eyeball. The other side, too.
Is there anything that you would care to share with our audience about your love for the trains?
Oh, not really. No. I don't have anything.
How long have you been a member?
Oh, about 25 years.
25 years?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, thank you for being a part of this display, because we know it takes a lot of coordination,
yep.
A lot of patience, and sweat and tears.
Yep. Yep.
But it is beautiful. That's why we're going around the whole displays right here for our community to be able to see those that weren't able to make it.
Yep. Yep. A lot of fun.
This is a long one, huh?
Yep. 60 cars.
50 cars?
60.
60, wow.
Yeah.
And no trouble, it's just going smoothly. That's the way you like to see it.
Yeah.
I'll give you the microphone.
Okay, that's good. So you want me to look at you? Yeah. So I'm Jim Spavins. I'm part of the Mohegan Pequot Model Railroad Club.
This layout I have in front of me is a two-rail O-scale layout, and I've named it the Tribute to Springfield. That's kind of the slang name for the train show by us vendors. And what it is it's actually a model of the rail spur that used to actually exist on the property here and serve the building that we're standing in. So it's kind of we call it freelancing. I've combined the old spur, which was taken out in the 70s, and the Railroad Hobby Show, which moved in the early 80s, to this building. So I have a lot of details from the current fairgrounds, so kind of people recognize where they are, and a lot of kind of fun train details along with that.
That's beautiful. This is just when we turned the corner, it's like you even had the Young building itself set up there.
Right. Yeah, so it's been fun. So part of the reason for building this layout was there's a lot of anniversaries happening right now with the fairgrounds and with the show. So last year was obviously the 100th anniversary of the Big E. This year it happens to be our 30th year exhibiting at the show, and next year is the 50th anniversary of the train show itself.
Wow.
So I wanted to kind of capture that with a model, kind of celebrate all these things that are happening.
And then I saw it right over here.
Yeah, so this past summer, every year there's a big national train show that moves around the country. We got invited to go, so I brought this layout and it was judged, and I took home second place in that, so it's pretty exciting. Yeah, so I got to spread the word of the train show a little bit, you know, around the country, and I had a lot of fun going out there and showing it off.
Well, I know Mayor Sarno would like the fact of the way you named the Springfield for the train.
Yeah, that's right.
You'll score big points with him.
Oh, good, good.
He's a good man. Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Jack Howie. I'm a member of the Mohegan Pequot Model Railroad Club. We're out of southeastern Connecticut, and this is our modular layout. We've actually had this here for 30 years now, on and off, but it's been rebuilt, most of it within the last 4 or 5 years. We've replaced a lot of the modules for the National Model Railroad Convention in Cleveland, and ended up winning first prize in the layout. And last year we took it back, a new part of the module, took it out to Indianapolis to the NMRA, and did very well out there too. But this particular module is my own module. It's from my house, and it is a modern day railroad museum. So it allows me to use trains from the Midwest, New England trains. We do a little bit of steam. We use it for teaching for kids, and so it's a little bit of everything. So.
And then you were saying, like, the tracks, how many feet of?
Yeah, there's about 300 feet linear feet right now set up, was my understanding, and it takes us, like I said, about an hour and a half to get it down, and we're waiting to get out of here till we get the vans in. Taking the setup, I think we can do it in probably 5 or 6 hours. Depends on, everybody's responsible for their own little setup. The biggest thing is just getting it leveled, and once we get it leveled and connected, then there's a electrical bus underneath, and it just plugs in, and we just go along and then put our little track connectors in to join everything together. So,
I love the detail. We see right there we have a theater with the flashlight.
The theater is on. If you notice, each building has its own microprocessor in it, so it's got random lights. If you look here, the school bus, the lighting sequence and the brakes will go on and off. If you go down the other end, there are some LEDs there's a little charcoal grill that's up there, and a guy with a fishing pole that will actually go up and down, although it's not operating right at the moment. If you noticed in here, a lot of these little people have flash cameras. There's a lot of little flash cameras which will go off every so often, and also in this car there are 13 people with flash cameras. So they turn on, turn off, and they'll do it on a random sequence.
Yeah.
And actually, as you go down the track there's a bunch of them down there in the rail fan park, and as a train comes by, they will actually take a picture of the people. Yep, you're very welcome. Enjoy.
More people come out and check out their website and stuff. And
yep, the website is up there.
Follow you around.
That's right. Thank you.
Can you say the website again?
Actually, it's the Mohegan Pequot Model Railroad Club. It's mprr.org, and you can find us there.
Interviewing everybody so we can give people, you know, the know-how of what's taking place with them. They'll be encouraged to come the next time themselves.
Oh, absolutely. This is a lot of exciting new products here at this. This is a great train show. My name's Rich Foster with MTH Electric Trains, and really at this show we're showing off our new DCS Wi-Fi. You can control your trains with your Droid or your Apple device now. So you can go to mthtrains.com and get your free app download from your Google Play or your iTunes store, and you can run your trains digitally now. So it's a very exciting, very prototypical way now to run your trains. You can access so many features. The hobby's come very far. So if you haven't been in the hobby for a while, come see what all the trains can do.
And when you're doing it, the app will tell you, you know, if you, which direction you want the trains to go in, or?
Well, you've got speed, so you can control your speed with just a touch of a button. You can forward, reverse. There are so many things you can control, all kind of sound functionality, uncouple cars anywhere on your layout, and do yard switching, control switches, control accessories, now with just a smart device. So it's so really the first one out there on the market can do all that.
Well, we're glad that we're able to find you. So this way here, we're scooping out the rest of the people.
That's right.
Okay.
So mthtrains.com, and come on out to the Big E Train Show. If you can't make it this year, come next year. It's a great train show. Bring the kids and have a great time.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
That. And we're just going to go and film some of the beautiful scenery that you have here with. Whoops, excuse me. Look, there's another one right over there to the left. Silver one. Silver bullet.